Hello, I'm Kwang Hee Jo. I'm in the master degree at the Chungnam National University, Professor Kwangbok East Lab. I give a presentation on a study on the effect of magnesium loaded on activated carbon and the process for enrichment and regeneration of ammonia. Contents are in the order of introduction, experiment, result and discussion, conclusions. Hydrogen is in the spotlight as a major energy carrier due to concerns over increasing environmental problems caused by fossil fuels. Among them, ammonia has been identified as one of the attractive and feasible hydrogen-laden chemicals. Also, ammonia is widely used in fertilizers, refrigeration, petroleum, chemical, and other industries. However, the Haber-Bosch process now accounts for 90% of the world's ammonia production. This process demands high pressures and temperatures. In addition, ammonia production emits large amounts of carbon dioxide due to the use of natural gas. As an alternative to this, the electrochemical ammonia synthesis method is an eco-friendly process. It does not emit carbon dioxide because of reacting nitrogen and water at atmospheric pressure and low temperature to produce ammonia. However, the concentration of ammonia produced at low conversion rate is very low. Therefore, it may be an alternative to obtain high concentration ammonia by adsorbing low concentration ammonia produced in the electrochemical ammonia synthesis method. In this study, activated carbon was selected because it is porous material and abundant. Considering the manufacture of metal-loaded carbon so that it can be stable at heat with repeated adsorption and desorption. In metal selection, magnesium is chosen as the metal and chloride as the precursor. Magnesium chloride adsorbs a total of 6 moles of ammonia per 1 mole and is a complete reversible reaction. It has a relatively low enthalpy of desorption, so it has already been studied as an ammonia storage material in many studies. However, it is not suitable for use with an adsorbent due to the slow reaction rate. Therefore, in the previous our study, we used it as an adsorbent by increasing the surface area by impregnating magnesium chloride on activated carbon. In this study, the optimal magnesium loaded amount for ammonia adsorption was selected, and the optimal process was selected in the TSA, PSA, and PTSA processes, and multi-cycles were performed. 3, 5, 7, 10, 50, and 20% magnesium were attached to activated carbon by sonication impregnation method. Activated carbon with nothing impregnated was named AC, and thus with 3% magnesium impregnated was named AC-Mg3. The ammonia adsorption test was carried out as a breakthrough test for TSA, PSA, and PTSA processes, and the breakthrough test conditions are shown in the table below. As a result of the BT analysis, the surface areas and pore volume of samples tend to decrease when magnesium was impregnated. However, the reduction in surface area and pore volume is insignificant when the amount of magnesium impregnated is more than 10 weight percent. In addition, the average pore size was constant for all adsorbents. As a result of TGA analysis, AC showed a rapid weight loss at 480 degrees, leaving a final 0.67 weight percent residue. On the other hand, the final weight of the magnesium loaded ACs are higher than that of AC, so we could confirm that the metal was successfully impregnated. Weight loss of magnesium loaded ACs begin at lower temperatures than AC. Nevertheless, it was confirmed that all adsorbents were thermally stable up to 360 degrees. SEM analysis was performed to confirm the surface morphology. AC confirmed a smooth surface and small particles were identified in magnesium-loaded ACs. These particles are clearly visible as the loading of magnesium increases. In particular, the low surface can be seen from ACMG10. As a result of EDX, it showed a magnesium weight percent consistent with the amount of magnesium impregnated to ACMG10. However, the magnesium content in ACMG15 and ACMG20 was 11.37 weight percent and 11.92 weight percent respectively, and the maximum maximum amount of magnesium that can be loaded is 10 weight percent. As a result of elemental mapping, magnesium and chloride were uniformly distributed on the surface of the activated carbon. It was confirmed that the distribution of magnesium and chloride was similar, so that they were impregnated in the form of magnesium chloride. In particular, the orange circle of ACMG20 suggests that the dispersion of magnesium and chloride is similar. Through NH3TPD analysis, the amount of adsorption was calculated at 30 to 200 degrees C. ACMG20 is 2.758 millimole per gram of adsorption capacity, and it is 17 times higher than AC. ACMG15 and ACMG10 showed similar amounts of adsorption within the error range of 2.733 millimole per gram and 2.674 millimole per gram respectively. Ammonia adsorption capacity of the adsorbent was in following order: ACMG20, ACMG50, ACMG10, ACMG7, ACMG5, ACMG3, AC. In order to confirm the optimal amount of magnesium loaded for ammonia adsorption at atmospheric pressure and high pressure, it was performed in the TSA and PSA processes. And the adsorption capacity is shown in a table. And magnesium chloride powder showed the lowest adsorption capacity due to the low reaction rate with ammonia. HMG-10 had the highest average adsorption capacity of 2.461 millimole per gram in the TSA processes and 1.298 millimole per gram in the second cycle of PSA process. Therefore, the optimal amount of magnesium impregnated for ammonia adsorption was determined to be 10 weight percent. The highest ammonia adsorption capacity, HMG-10, was performed in the PTSA process, which was readsorbed after desorption at a mild temperature of 100 degrees C. It showed an adsorption capacity of 2.769 millimole per gram and a regeneration rate of about 68% compared to first cycle. It was confirmed that HMG-10 could be used in TSA, PSA, and PTSA processes. After desorption at 100 degrees C, readsorption was repeatedly performed 20 cycles. Average of adsorption capacity showed 2.783 millimole per gram. Even with repeated adsorption and desorption, thermal stability and activity stability were confirmed without lowering the adsorption capacity. The conclusion is that magnesium-loaded AC was synthesized by varying the amount of magnesium impregnated using magnesium chloride. The maximum loaded magnesium was confirmed to be 10 weight percent throughout EDX from ammonia TPD, TSA, and PSA research. HMG-10 was identified as the most optimal adsorbent for ammonia adsorption. HMG-10 shows high regeneration when desorption and readsorption at a mild temperature of 100 degrees C, and its applicability in TSA, PSA, and PTSA process was confirmed. As a result of the multi-cycle, thermal stability and activity stability were confirmed. HMG was confirmed as a good adsorbent in the ammonia concentration processes. Thank you for your attention.